Hi friends, welcome to EduTab. So welcome to the Fast Track series for NABARD Grade A 2018 brought to you by EduTab. Now this is a short series where each day we come up with important concepts and data points that are important for our NABARD Grade A 2018 examination. So kindly revise the series ample number of times to retain the facts. Today is lecture number 9. So friends, the NABARD Grade A admit cards are out and the prelims shall be held on 19th May 2018 and the mains shall be held on 17th of June 2018. EduTab is providing the comprehensive course for NABARD Grade A 2018 for a discounted price of Rs. 5000. We also provide NABARD Phase 1 plus Phase 2 Current Affairs Punch course for Rs. 3000. It is a consolidated course wherein you get all the current affairs at one place. We have also come up with a new course, that is NABARD Grade A 2018 Test Series for Phase 1 and Phase 2. You can get this course for Rs. 1500. If you have any doubt regarding our course, you can visit our website www.edutab.co.in. You can also drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in or you can give us a call at 814-620-7241. Friends, what are we going to have a look at today? So basically in this lecture, we shall be having a look at certain important data points. Okay, so here we're not going to have a discussion regarding any concept as of today, but we shall be having a look at those important things that you need to memorize before you step in for the examination, right? So let us begin with the first thing. The first thing says the availability of the nutrients with the pH levels. So we need to understand that based upon the value of the pH, the availability of various nutrient varies. Okay, so here you can have a look at the snapshot. So here, as we know that the pH ranges are given, like pH less than 6, that is acidic in nature, the soil would be. Then you have pH 6 to 6.5 and pH greater than 7. Okay, that is soil is going to be alkaline in nature. Right. So basically here, if you see, you need to memorize this particular tabular column that is given. So that means if availability of calcium and molybdenum increases with increase in pH, that means you can see that if a particular soil is alkaline or its pH increases, then you can see that calcium and molybdenum availability also increases. So these particular nutrients are suitable when there is alkaline conditions prevalent, right? So when here you can see in acidic soils, that is when the pH is less than 6, you can have a look at here. So iron, aluminium, manganese and zinc, the concentration of these particular nutrients, okay, it increases. So basically they are suitable or they're present in such soils that have less pH or which are acidic in nature. Now in exam, there can be a question regarding this availability of various nutrients varying with the pH values. So you need to kindly pause the video and make sure that you know at what pH which nutrient concentration increases or decreases, right? Okay, the next one, if you see, you can see a snapshot here where the commercial propagation methods for major fruit crops is given. Okay, now this is a very important list that you can see here. So basically, what is meant by commercial propagation, right? So basically, when you say to propagate a plant, it means to breed or create a new plant. Right. So from where are you actually creating this new plant? From using a parent plant. Okay. Or you can use only the parts, like you can use either seed, you can use cuttings from other plants. Right. So we are not going to go into the detail of these things, but just overview. When I say what is propagation, that means you are breeding a new plant. Okay. Generally, plants, if you see, they propagate through two different means. One is a sexual propagation and the other is a asexual propagation. Okay, they can breed naturally or it can also be guided by humans. Okay, so we are not going to go into various methods and what are the process that involves in each of these methods. Basically, our intention is to only have a look at the list that you can see on your screens. For example, when you say grape, okay, so you need to know that one of the propagation methods is hardwood cutting. Okay, so when I say lychee, okay, so it's going to be air layering, a method which is used in this kind of the propagation of lychee. right? So what you need to do is make sure that you pause this video, then and there finish it off. Because in exam, if you get one of the questions from this particular tabular column, then actually you can get one solid mark. Okay, so make sure you do not postpone this, but as you are watching this video, pause the video in between and kindly memorize this particular list. Okay friends, so the third thing that we're going to have a look at today is a list which is given on your screens, that is the causes of the color and the bitterness in various fruits and vegetables, right? Now this is a very important list because in day to day we know that, you know, we use these vegetables and fruits, okay, and we need to know the reason behind the various kind of smell that we experience and the color that we see. So kindly, again I would say, pause this video, take 5 to 10 minutes and make sure that you are at least aware of the common ones, right? For example, the redness of apple is due to what? Anthocyanin, right? For example, you can say the pungency in chili is due to what? Okay, it's capsaicin. So you can get one question based on this as well, right? So for example, if you see garlic, okay, we know it has a very pungent smell. So why is that smell? It is due to the presence of dialyl disulfide. Okay, so it may seem tough, but you need to make that effort to make sure that you know these basic things. This is a very basic thing when it comes to agriculture. Right? So friends, with this we have come to the end of this video today. So basically this was a short lecture, but it is an important one because these are some of the important data points that you need to memorize. Like the first thing that we saw was the availability of the various nutrients depending upon the pH levels, right? You need to know that. The second thing, we saw some of the common propagation methods that are used in some of the fruit crops, okay? Again, you need to know those names. And then we had also seen the reason for the, you know, the smell or the color present in the various fruits and vegetables. What are the pigments? What are the organic forms that are present? So kindly make sure you know the names and you know the reasons for it, right? If you found this video useful, kindly like, subscribe and share. And the PDF format of this particular video can be accessed from EduTab's Telegram channel, and the link for the channel is placed on your screens. Till then friends, thank you so much and happy learning.